Hi, it's Heather, the Adult Services Librarian at Gardenham Community Library. I facilitate our book group, and I'm here to tell you about our 2023 reading selections. These titles were suggested by and voted upon at our December meeting of the group. So, in February, our selection is The Fates and the Furies by Lauren Groff, the award-winning New York Times bestselling author of The Monsters of Templeton and Arcadia. This novel looks at marriage, creativity, art, and perception. It examines a marriage as well as a portrait of a creative partnership. Every story has two sides, every relationship has two perspectives, and sometimes it turns out the key to a great marriage is not its truths, but its secrets. At the core of this rich, expansive, layered novel, Lauren Groff presents the story of one such marriage over the course of 24 years. March's book is The Last Picture Show by Larry McMurtry. This classic, rambunctious coming-of-age story is an elegy to a forlorn Texas town trying to keep its one movie house alive. Adapted into the Oscar-winning film, the book immortalizes the lives of the hardscrabble residents who are threatened by the forces of the modern world. If you're a fan of John Irving, Mary Doria Russell, Pat Conroy, this book will likely appeal to you. In April, we'll discuss Parable of the Sower by Octavia E. Butler. This is a post-apocalyptic science fiction novel that provides commentary on climate change and social inequality. The story follows Lauren Olamina, a young woman who can feel the pain of others and becomes displaced from her home. This is the first of two books, and it's a Nebula Award winner, a New York Times notable, and a 2020 New York Times bestseller, which was 30 years after its original publication date. It's been announced that this book is currently being adapted into a film. In May, we're reading The Mystery, Bruno, Chief of Police by Martin Walker, which is book one of a series. Benoit Courager, affectionately named Bruno, as in the title, is chief of police in a small village in the south of France, where the rituals of the café still rule. A former soldier, Bruno has embraced the slow rhythms of country life, but the murder of an elderly North African who fought in the French army galvanizes his attention. The man had a swastika carved into his chest. When a visiting scholar helps untangle the dead man's past, Bruno's suspicions turn towards a motive more complex than hate, back to a tortured period of French history. This book series seems perfect for fans of Donna Leone and Louise Panning. In June, we'll have a special guest, author Jackie Shannon Hollis, who is the author of This Particular Happiness, a childless love story, and a nonfiction memoir. When Jackie marries Bill, a man who doesn't want children, she joyfully commits to the childless life, but soon after the wedding, after visiting a family in rural Oregon and holding her newborn niece, she falls deeply into baby love and longing and begins to question her decision as she navigates the overlapping roles of wife, daughter, aunt, sister, survivor, counselor, and friend. She explores what it really means to choose a different path. This Particular Happiness delves into the messy and beautiful territory of what we keep and what we abandon to make space for love. For July, our selection is Icebound, Shipwrecked at the Edge of the World by Andrea Pitzer. This book tells the astonishing real-life survival tale of Dutch explorer William Barents and his crew, who in the 16th century ventured farther north than any Europeans before. On their third polar exploration, they lost their ship off the frozen coast of Nova Zembla due to unforgiving ice. The men spent the next year fighting off ravenous polar bears, gnawing hunger, an endless winter. Pitzer masterfully combines this gripping tale of survival with a sweeping history of the great age of exploration, a time of hope, adventure, and seemingly unlimited geographic frontiers. For August, we return to mystery. Our selection, The Third Victim, is book one in local author Philip Margolin's Robin Lockwood series. In rural Oregon, two women are found dead after being tortured, battered, and burned. A third woman escapes with evidence that points overwhelmingly to a local man. When a young lawyer joins the team defending him, She uncovers corruption, lies, and secrets that threaten to shake up not only her firm, but the entire town. This book is perfect for anyone who loves authors such as John Grisham, Linda Fairstein, and David Ellis. And Philip Margolin will be joining us for our meeting that month. In September, we'll discuss The 100 Years of Lenny and Margot by Marianne Cronin. Determined to leave a mark on the world even though they are in the hospital and their days are dwindling, unlikely friends, 17-year-old Lenny and 83-year-old Margot devise a plan to create 100 paintings showcasing the century that they've lived. This novel is a 2021 American Library Association Alex Award winner for adult books with special appeal to young adults aged 12 through 18. Our October selection is The Violin Conspiracy by Brendan Slocum, a riveting page-turner about a black classical musician's desperate quest to recover his lost violin on the eve of the most prestigious musical competition in the world. Booklist described the book as a galvanizing blend of thriller, coming-of-age drama, and probing portrait of racism. This flawless debut will do for classical music what the Queen's Gambit did for chess. In November, we'll discuss West with Giraffes by Linda Rutledge. It's 1938. The Great Depression lingers, Hitler threatens Europe, and world-weary Americans long for wonder. They find it in two giraffes who miraculously survive a hurricane while crossing the Atlantic. What follows is a 12-day road trip in a custom truck to deliver Southern California's first giraffes to the San Diego Zoo. Inspired by true events, this tale weaves real-life figures with fictional ones, including the world's first female zoo director, a crusty old man with a past, a young female photographer with a secret, and assorted reprobates as spotty as the giraffes. Part adventure, part historical saga, and part coming-of-age love story. In December, we have our selection meeting, so we don't have a book for that month. But in January of 2024, we'll read Geraldine Brooks' newest, Horse. A discarded painting in a junk pile, a skeleton in an attic, and the greatest racehorse in American history. From these strands, the Pulitzer Prize-winning Brooks braids a sweeping story of spirit, obsession, and injustice across American history. The novel spans 1850 to 2019, and is based on the remarkable true story of the record-breaking thoroughbred Lexington. Horse is a novel of art and science, love and obsession, and our unfinished reckoning with racism. For fans of Tracy Chevalier and Charles Frazier, among others. And our February 2024 selection is The Night Circus. Fans of J.K. Rowling, Susanna Clarke, and all forms of magical realism were buzzing upon the debut of this novel by Erin Morgenstern. Waging a fierce competition for which they have trained since childhood, circus magicians Celia and Marco unexpectedly fall in love with each other and share a fantastical romance that manifests in fateful ways. Those are our books for the next year for our book group. If you're interested in finding out the full schedule or need to contact us, please click the links below. Thanks.